Morgan awoke with snot all over her face. Not just her nose or mouth, but all over it. Her eyelids, her cheeks, her forehead. She wiped the slime off her eyelids so she could see. A great puddle of clear slime coated the pillow. Too much slime to be produced by a human's runny nose. Slime dripped into Morgan's eyes again. But my nose isn't on my forehead. Morgan cleared her eyes of slime and headed to the mirror. A clear sheet of slime clung to her forehead, with thinner films covering her cheeks and lips. Her nose was not running. She ran to the bathroom and scrubbed her face with the toilet paper. Morgan tossed wads of toilet paper into the toilet and flushed. The slime just felt too unclean, too diseased to place in the trash can. Morgan's face felt sore and raw and wet? Morgan wiped her face again. The toilet paper came back soggy with slime. Already? But I... Mom! Her mother did not respond. This is not a good time to be reading the newspaper, Morgan thought. Mom! I'm coming! I'm coming! Morgan heard the creak of the stairs and the stomp of feet outside the bathroom. Mom, I think I'm sick. There's snot all over my face, Morgan said from within the bathroom, still trying to clean her face. So it's time, her mother said, oddly cheery considering the circumstances. My child is becoming a woman. What? No, Morgan spluttered out, her slimy face hot with embarrassment. Nobody gets slime. It's just a part of growing up, dear. It's puberty. I tried giving you the book, but you wouldn't read it. Slime dripped into Morgan's eyes. She clenched them shut and reached for another wad of toilet paper. No, 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 no. Morgan held her head in her hands, slime dripping down like viscous tears. Make it stop. Fix it. It's just natural, her mother said, still calm. Too calm. Finish up in there and get ready for school. No, not school. Not like this. Morgan's mother was already downstairs. Morgan went through her classes armed with all the tissue boxes in the house. She felt uncomfortable, diseased, wrong. But no one at school noticed her discomfort or the copious amount of tissues. At lunchtime, she stopped by the nurse. I'm ill. I should go home, she told the nurse. What are your symptoms exactly? Slime. Slime everywhere on my face. She wondered why the nurse couldn't see it herself. It was on her face, after all. You're becoming a woman, the nurse said. Get rid of it! You're a nurse! The nurse frowned, sighed, and headed to a room in the back. She returned with a box of tissues. There, now you can return the class, she said, and went into her office. I don't want tissues! What's with... why? The nurse closed the door to her office and ignored her. Once Morgan was home from school, she was greeted by her mother calling from the kitchen. Morgan, dear, I want you to come here. Morgan! Coming! Her mother stood by the kitchen table with a look of concern. Really, you should have read that book if you didn't want to be surprised. Though I can't imagine. Well, see for yourself. Nothing to be ashamed of. Morgan's mother started to undress. Morgan stood shocked. She covered her eyes with her hands. It's just a body, Morgan. You will soon have one just like this. Her mother's voice floated through the darkness. Slimy hands gripped her own, taking them away from her face. Slimy? What? Morgan lost her focus and opened her eyes. See? Nothing to be afraid of. Her mother's voice emanated from the dark orifice of the thing's head. You're just becoming a woman.